Hello everyone, welcome to another video, and this time I'm going to show you how you can use your existing mobile phone, in this case I have a spare iPhone, to act as a classroom visualizer, so you could use it in your classroom or in your online lessons. Right, first of all you need a mobile device, which is in my case this iPhone 7 here. Second, you need an app that is called iDocCam from IPEVO. So go to the App Store and you need to look for it. So if you spell iDocCam, I will leave a link in the description below. And then there we go, iDocCam. I'm going to download this. Right, third, you will need something to hold your iPhone. In this case, I'll be using clamp with a mount that looks like this. Now, all the overhead shots that you have been watching in my videos, my YouTube channel, is recorded using this clamp and this mount. Right, this costs about less than £15 from Amazon and you can get cheaper on eBay. It comes with a mobile phone mount, which fits most phones. Here's another example of a clamp you can use, and it's highly customizable, whereby you can move it at any angle and however close or further you like to position it. It's very, very customizable. Here's another example with a ring light attached to it, which is quite cool. Or if you're on a tight budget, why don't you try this method from a teacher shared on Twitter? You know, using existing items around your house and create a makeshift stand like this, which is quite cool. Now here's, I've got the app. Now I'm gonna open it. And there we go. So I'm gonna give access to the camera because obviously I'm gonna use my camera. Okay, and then there's a notification. I'm gonna tap got it. And there we go. I've got it here. So here is the app. I can put my notes, I can do my writing on it, underneath it. And there's several configurations here, which I'm going to show you. Now here is a light configuration where you can turn on the LED light at the back. So for example, if I tap on it, and then there we go, as you can see, it's light from the back. And I can change the exposure. And then I can change white balance to make it a little more warmer. For example, warmer or colder, whatever you like. And then I can change my auto focus mode, whether I want a manual focus, continuous, or single shot. Want to keep it the same focus at the same time, but I would suggest you keep it in continuous focus, so as you move around it will automatically focus on that. And then last but not least, there's a button here, it's called freeze. We can just freeze the frame, whatever I'm on right now, freeze, so whatever underneath is frozen. And then last one, there's this hide button or blank button. Basically I will just shut the screen. There we go. Okay, so it saves power of your screen. And then you can switch camera. So this is now at the moment using the rear camera, the back camera. However, if I switch it, now there's the front camera. I'm recording right now with my iPhone. And then there we go. Right, now step number 5 is how to connect your phone to your computer or your desktop. So what you would need is a software called Visualiser from IPEVO. So you need to go to ipevo.com and then click on software. And then there's the first app is called IPEVO Visualiser. You click on it. And then on the top right, there's a free download icon. Click on it and select what your desktop is. Is it a Mac? Is it a Windows? Or is it a Chrome? So I'm going to click on Mac. And then it should open the Mac App Store. So now it's opening the Mac App Store. There we go. And now that's the app. So I can just download the app, and in this case I already downloaded it, and I can open the app straight away. Right, so the next important step is step number 6, which is to make sure both of your devices, your laptop, your desktop, and your mobile phone must be connected on the same network. So you should go to settings and check whether they are on the same Wi-Fi network. Right, now step number 7 is for you to open the Visualiser app or software, and you need to change the camera source. So if you go to the top left, there should be an icon to select the camera, and then you need to select iDocCam iPhone or the name of your iPhone as a camera source. And then once you clicked on it, there you go. You should see what your phone is seeing on your desktop or your laptop. That's it, easy peasy. Now a bonus step is to use a picture-in-picture and have two camera sources at once. So at the bottom right, there's an icon to click to picture-to-picture, and there should be another camera shown up, and you can change your camera source, whether your webcam, or in this case, I use another iPhone that I have. So I have two iPhones connected to my desktop. So how cool is that? This is so, so good. Right, I hope this video has been useful. If you have any questions, leave it down below. I put all the links in the description. And see you in the next one, guys. Bye.